How can filling out a pledge card for the combined federal campaign make a difference? It can help provide the means for important medical research. It can mean a higher education, where once there was little hope. And it can help make the difference between a bleak ecological future and future growth. Catch the spirit of giving. Designate your favorite charity and give generously.
The art of the Native American often reflected the environment from which it came. The Arctic region reflected long winter nights working wood and stone into imaginative forms. In the northwestern region, vast cedar forests supplied wood for some of the most spectacular wooden art ever developed by the Indian. In the southwest, there is a rich variety of art expressions from pottery to silver. The vast plains region provided animal hides, which were fashioned as wearable art. Beautiful wood and stone carvings are also common. While in the northeast region, craftsmen used native hardwood, twine, and antler to produce finely woven and carved works of art. The southeastern artists used their skills to create the elaborate patchwork, which formed brightly colored dolls and clothing. With the introduction of new materials by the settlers, a whole new world opened up for the Indian artist. We have much to learn from these artistic pioneers during American Indian Heritage Month. If you get hooked on smoking as a teen, you've got a lot to look forward to as an adult. First, there's the hassle of just finding a place to smoke. Socially, you can look forward to a little rejection. And down the road, it can even hurt your job prospects. Smoking, it can really make life a drag.
Situated on Maine's rocky coast, Acadia is America's second most visited national park. Hoping to stop commercial development, the local residents donated the land here to the federal government in 1916. 3 years later, President Woodrow Wilson preserved 38,000 acres, making Acadia the first national park east of the Mississippi. Thanks to the vision of its founders, the unique natural beauty of Acadia National Park is protected now for all Americans to see and enjoy.
Today we are going to discuss... Excuse me, I'll get out of the way just a moment. Please. Thank you. Idiot. Today we are going to discuss your personal safety when traveling in a foreign country. Next, please. Not as this well-informed military traveler knows how to use the local phone system. Next, please. And he also has the correct currency. Next. Try not to be the obvious American. Where is he? Yes, try to be as inconspicuous as possible. Next. Visit places where you can get to know the local people and their customs. Who took this picture? Pay no attention to the man in the plaid jacket. Yes, well, that ends today's lesson in anti-terrorism techniques. Don't be funny with me.
Katie Brunell. She was a color bearer with her husband's regiment during the Civil War. Once, before a major battle, troops from her regiment didn't recognize Katie's company. As the troops were about to fire on her company, Katie ran out in front, waving the colors to save her comrades. Katie Brunell, another of the many women who served America bravely in time of war.
It began in the fall of 1621 in Plymouth, Massachusetts. The preceding winter, half of the colony's population had died of hunger and disease. But those who remained held fast in their determination to succeed. Their future was uncertain, but the bountiful harvest of 1621 helped to ensure the Pilgrims' survival during the coming harsh New England winter. Through courage and perseverance, the early settlers thrived in the new world. Hope was restored, and the colony flourished. Near the end of the harvest season, the colonies set aside a special day to celebrate and give thanks. Nearly 400 years later, Americans still celebrate a day of Thanksgiving because we still have much to be thankful for.
Every year, in mid-September, people come from near and far to Mitchell, South Dakota, to see the world's only corn palace. In 1892, the local residents decided to encourage people to come live in South Dakota by showing off their people and products in a great Corn Belt exposition. They constructed a building for the exposition and throughout the years decorated it from top to bottom with multicolored grains and grasses. The Corn Palace, completed in 1921, has hosted entertainers from John Philip Sousa to Bob Hope to popular country music artists of today. In the summer, all of the decorations from the previous year are removed and a whole new theme is designed for the coming festival. South Dakota's Corn Palace. It's one of a kind.
Though seldom seen, they are out there, living in waterways along America's east and Gulf coasts. Diamondback terrapins, creatures more ancient even than they look, whose ancestors lived here 250 million years ago. The unique design on their shell distinguishes the diamondbacks and gives them their name. Terrapins have a checkered history. They've crept into Native American myths and legends and serve the American taste for unusual cuisine. A popular fellow, the terrapin was almost hunted into extinction. But through the efforts of conservationists, once again, the intrepid terrapin will continue its slow and inexorable march through time.
The pioneering missionaries who ventured into Wisconsin several hundred years ago and stumbled upon these islands named them the Apostle Islands. At the time, they thought there were only 12, but in fact, there are 22 islands clustered off the Bayfield Peninsula in Lake Superior. The islands range in size from one tiny islet to another with more than 14,000 acres, some populated by nothing more than deer, bear, and birds. And they have been this way for hundreds of years.
As our knowledge constantly expands and we reach to unlock mysteries and discover new worlds, it becomes increasingly important to pay attention to the place we call home. One way you can make things better is by contributing to the Combined Federal Campaign. Your contribution can help hundreds of organizations make our home a better place. For so many people, in so many ways, please give to the CFC. Your contribution is an important part of a global effort.
I've always wanted to be like a Roy.
Are you making fun of me?
You used to take care of me all the time. Make sure I never did anything wrong. Just hang around Eric and my mom. And me. Then things started to change. He started taking money from my mom. Everybody told me he was on drugs. I couldn't believe it. Not my group. But it was true. Drugs killed my brother. Ah! Yeah. I miss him.
Ask any Jack Tar who's rounded the Cape, there's nothing like a storm at sea. But as bad as it gets, sailors still have their duty to perform. And their only shelter is the clothes on their backs. First it was tarp canvas, later oiled cloth, then rubberized fabric. Today, new synthetics provide a combination of waterproofing, breathability, and maneuverability. We can't change the weather, but at least the Navy can change the way to dress for it. American military uniforms, symbols of pride.
Sarah Breedlove Walker was born in 1867 on the Louisiana Delta. Orphaned at age 7, married at 14, a single mother at 19. In 1904, while attending the St. Louis World's Fair, Sarah heard Mrs. Booker T. Washington's address on pride and self-esteem. Sarah reasoned that if she improved her own appearance, she could improve her position in life. But her hair was a problem. It was thinning and showed bare spots. In a dream, Sarah claimed to have learned the ingredients for a hair tonic. Based on the success of this recipe, she developed a line of hair care products. Known professionally as Madam C.J. Walker, she formed a sales force of agents going door to door, expanding sales of her product across the country. By 1918, she was the country's first black woman millionaire. Madam C.J. Walker, a story of American ingenuity.
Doesn't look like much now, but American commercial radio broadcasting began here. In the early days of radio, the operators discussed radio equipment on the air. But in 1919, Frank Conrad, broadcasting from his garage, tried something different. He relayed baseball scores and local news. Then he played a song from a record. The response was enthusiastic, and Conrad was overwhelmed by song requests, a first for radio. He soon ran out of records to play, but a local music store offered him a supply. In exchange, he mentioned where people could buy the records. The first radio advertising. H.P. Davis saw an ad that mentioned Conrad's broadcasts. He realized there was an audience out there for regular radio programming. Davis and Conrad together built the nation's first radio station, KDKA in Pittsburgh. The rest is radio history.
On the streets and sidewalks of America, there are performers playing for fun and front.
Fred Rogers. You know, making music can be a mighty healthy way for us to express ourselves. It can become a child's way if that child is encouraged to use it early on. It's music educators who can help generations of young people find such healthy ways in life. Please call this toll-free number to find out more about how you can support music in the schools. Music for a sound education.
There are lots of tourist attractions in America, and some of them have gone through pretty rough times. Like the battleship USS Alabama. But times have really changed for the Alabama. Now it too is a tourist attraction in Mobile Bay.
Battleship Alabama was due to be scrapped in 1963. She was brought here through donations raised by corporate citizens of the state and also school children, some 3 million Alabamians contributing over $1 million. She came in 1964 in September and was open to the public January 9, 1965.
Now, if you've never seen a battleship, you're missing out. 2,500 men used to live on this ship during World War II. There are 12 decks above the main deck and 7 decks below. And its 16-inch guns will lob these babies up to 21 miles with deadly accuracy.
The battleship and Battleship Park are not just dedicated to Alabamians who have served in the military, but also to all Americans.
Thank you.
Before astronauts do this, they spend many hours practicing for their space flight in all kinds of simulators. Moving underwater simulates the weightlessness of space. Here, an astronaut practices manipulating the space shuttle's robotic arm. Astronauts fly Gulfstream jets to get a feel for handling the space shuttle. They also practice safety procedures, such as getting away from the shuttle and launch pad in case of an emergency, and leaving the shuttle using a flotation slide. Several weeks before the scheduled flight, the crew and flight controllers come together to practice the entire mission, a dress rehearsal for the real thing. All that practicing can duplicate everything, except for that first-time thrill of being in space.
You guys, this is it.
Oh, let's see.
This is the dress I want for the dance. I'm so psyched for this.
Cool.
I don't even want to go.
You look great in that color.
It's really hot.
Why don't you want to go, Megan?
Because Michael keeps asking me to have sex. And, like, I don't know what to say.
You mean, like, how to say no without hurting his feelings?
Yeah.
It's so hard.
Just say something like, I really care about you, Michael, but I'm just not ready for that.
I say, look what time it is. I have to get home.
Just say, no, I've decided it's not a good idea for me right now.
Oh, Lisa, I'm sorry.
When you think about it, there are a number of good ways to say no to having sex. You just need to find the one that's right for you.
Mm. I wish you were going to the dance, Megan.
So what are you going to do about Michael?
I'm going to say no. N-O.
Good. All right, guys.
In the land of Butch Cassidy, in eastern Utah, are 75,000 acres of sandstone hills, shifted and shaped by wind, water, ice, and heat into remarkable natural carvings. Sculptures that inspire the imagination, like Delicate Arch, or defy logic like Landscape Bridge. Unlike any other place on Earth, Arches National Park contains close to 1,500 holes, arches, and bridges. An awe-inspiring collection of the random art of time.
Mention home sweet home and we all picture something different. American architecture, like the rest of our culture, grew from the past. When our country began, Americans looked back to Europe for inspiration on building their homes. They chose the best of what other cultures had to offer and reinterpreted the designs for a new country and new cultures. American homes can look like English cottages or classical Greek and Roman temples, like Gothic cathedrals and Victorian mansions, or haciendas that blend the best of Spanish and Indian cultures. Americans have also looked to the land and the frontier. We live in modern log cabins or homes that seem part of the landscape itself. There are as many variations of the typical American home as there are Americans. Wherever you go in this country, home may look a little different, but it always feels the same.
This is the sound of healthy lungs. Now, listen. This is asthma. Did you know it can sometimes kill you? Kenneth does. Like 3 million other children under 18 in the United States, Kenneth has asthma.
I feel sad, and I'm kind of scared.
Through American Lung Association programs, children with asthma can sound like this.
America, we have a lot to be thankful for.
They discovered the gas in England
made it glow in France. But it was good old American ingenuity that created the first neon signs. To make the gas light up, they filled a glass tube with neon, put an electrode at either end, and ran in 15,000 volts, turning the gas into a glowing band of color. Now seen coast to coast, neon tells us where to go and what to do when we get there. It draws us in, makes us smile. Neon, one of America's bright spots.
The fortresses that dotted the early landscapes of Europe, Africa, and the Middle East were built to deter and protect against enemy attacks. That mission of deterrence continues today by the men and women who serve under the United States European Command. From the North Cape of Norway to the Baltic and Mediterranean seas, through parts of the Middle East to the Cape of Good Hope, the men and women of EUCOM, unified for strength.
With the help of the college fund, I went to college. It prepared me for graduate school and other challenges, like being married to this guy.
Help young people reach their potential. A mind is a terrible thing to waste. Please support the college fund. What do you mean, challenge?